If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay student, welcome you all to this new lecture on analog electronics. So today we will be solving from question number 61 onwards up to question number 65. Five questions. Questions are based on generally op-amps. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions. So come to 61. What is there in 61? In the given figure shows that non-inverting op-amp summer with V1 this, V2 this, and that, then the output voltage there. So what will be your output voltage? If you see this one, this potential, I told you that should be in same, because if it is a feedback, you keep it same. And I think this is also given. This is 2R, correct it, okay? Please modify this one. This is 2R, okay? If this is also given, then you try. So what will be the, we go for nodal analysis. You will see in op-amp, this potential are at same potential. So you draw a nodal here, you draw a nodal here. Then you will find the answer. A very simple one for op-amp and very scoring also. So if you try with this one, what will be the nodal at first? Suppose if I take nodal here, then it will be, you can take it outgoing current. So V minus 2 by R. Outgoing current V minus minus 1 by R. And here outgoing current V by R. All is equal to 0. So from here, if you calculate, your V will be equal to RR would get cancelled, you will get V equal to 1 by. Then you take nodal here, so again V minus 0 by R, this current outgoing, because this node becomes the other, so everything is coming out of it, V minus V naught by 2R, that is equal to 0. So from here, if you solve here, your V naught will be equal to 3 into V, which is 1 volt. V is equal to your 1/3, so you put it there. Don't confuse with that volt, it is not volt, 3 into V, so this V is 1 by 3, so it is 1. A non-inverting op-amp amplifier is shown in here, okay. So a non-inverting op-amp is shown here, same, it is a feedback, negative feedback connected to minus terminal, it is grounded, same thing we will do, we will take nodal here, we will take, so you can assume this voltage to be V or Vx, whatever you feel comfortable with. So what will be this voltage? Suppose this is outgoing voltage, so if I go, it is V minus minus 2 divided by R. I'm taking nodal here, so B minus V minus 2 by R, then plus, no current flows through here, so only these two current out of B, how many currents are flowing? One is this direction, one is this. No current is in this direction because this is infinite resistance. Forget about current between these two, okay. Then this again B minus 2 plus sine 100 t divided by R. B minus 2 plus sine 100 t divided by R, okay. Then V minus minus 2 by R equal to 0. So from here, if you solve it, you will find your V is equal to 2 will get cancelled, it will be sine 100 t. Okay, now if you take again nodal here, so if you take nodal here, it will be V minus 0 by R plus V minus, this is V naught by R. So from here, if you solve, it will be V is V naught will be equal to 2V. So again you make this correction, this is 2R, so you make all these corrections. I will try to also make it in the question sheet. This is again 2R, so there is a mistake in the question, you kindly modify this one. So it will be again, what it will be, then it will be 2V and then V, 3V, so it will be 3V. So if you do now this one, so your V naught will be equal to 3 into this one, it is 2V equal to, sorry, so V will be equal to sine 100 t by 2. So it will be, the answer will be 3 by 2 sine 100 t. That is your option A. Now in question number 63, let the magnitude of the gain of the inverting op-amp circuit shown be X, which switch S1 is open. Now if you open it, then it is X. When the switch is closed, then the magnitude of gain becomes. When you close, then there will be in feedback path, then it will be only 1R. When you open it, then there will be 2R. That's the difference only. So what is the gain? There are also formulas are also there, but I always prefer you go by simple nodal. So if it is 0, then this is also 0. So what we will do, if I take nodal here, in the first case, suppose it is open, now let us say that is X. When S is open, let us say that is X. So I am calculating X now. So what will be X? It will be 0 minus Vi by R, then plus 0 minus V naught by 2R. That is equal to 0, because this is at 0 ground, so this is at 0, so this point is at 0, so I am taking nodal, so 0 minus this divided by R, 0 minus this, only two currents are flowing out of this. If I take nodal here, two currents are flowing, no current flows through here, there is no current, forget about these two, so only these two current, that's what I have written here. So here what will be, R would get cancelled, so you will find V naught equal to minus 2 Vi. So V naught by Vi is equal to minus 2. So that is your x, suppose. Okay, now if you sort it, what will be now? Now it will be V0 minus V naught by R, then this will be 0 minus V naught by not 2R, now it will be R. So here your V naught will be equal to RR get cancelled minus Vi. So here V naught by Vi will be equal to minus 1, which is half of that x. So original x now becomes x by 2, it will be reduced by half 2. So simple nodal you take, then it will come. 64, the major advantage of active filter. I think this one we have already studied in a circuit also. Active filter means using op-amp, capacitor, resistance, that's it, a active filter. So they don't use inductor, which is an advantage because inductors normally take bulky, becomes bulky. So that's why if you remove inductor, so that will be easily realized, and that is the advantage. So that's why it is not there. Line 65, they ask to match, which one is this one. Now if you see question number A, circuit A, there is no feedback. As there is no feedback, that means it is just comparing V1 and V2. Because it is open loop, op-amp, what they do, they compare between V1 and V2. And A into V1 minus V2 is the output. That is the formula for open loop. Simple formula, A into V1 minus V2, if it is open loop. If it is ideal, then common mode is, that doesn't come, so only differential mode comes. Because it is the infinite, then that is we treat zero. So it is just comparing between V1. If one get positive, then output will change. Suppose this inverting gets more, this terminal gets more, then this voltage will be just opposite to what you have given here. If it gets more, then it will directly come here. So that is your A. So A is obviously comparator. So that is, A is connected to R. That is simple. Now for B, what you do, you take any value of resistance and capacitance and try to calculate it. So let me take R1, 1 and C also 1. And let me convert it into Laplace, so it will be 1 by S. And now you can try using same nodal here. So if it is at 0, no current is flowing through this, so this is also 0. So if you take nodal here, 0 minus Vi by 1 plus 0 minus V naught by this. Now these two is 1 ohm is in parallel with 1 by S. Resistance and capacitance are parallel, so C I have considered 1 farad, because only you need to see either it is low pass or high pass, no need to go for exit value, so that's why I've chosen 1, which is easy. So it will be 1 by S and then 1 plus 1 by S. And what it will be? 1 by S plus 1. So it will be 1 by S plus 1, that is equal to 0. So if you do here, it will be Vi is equal to minus Vi is equal to V naught into S plus 1. Or you need V naught by Vi, which is equal to V naught by Vi will be equal to 1 by S plus 1. So this is the characteristic. So 1 by S plus 1 means 1 by J omega plus 1. If you see. Now if you think, if it is a low pass or high pass. Low pass you put F equal to omega equal to 0, and high pass for you put omega equal to infinity. Low pass means low frequency, high pass means high frequency. This is for low pass, this is for high pass. See who, in which case you are getting output. If omega equal to 0, then your gain is infinity. Infinity gain means obviously you are getting output. And your high pass, if it is high pass, gain is very high. If your frequency is very high, then your gain is zero. Gain zero means you will not get any output. That means V0 will be zero. So that means it is not allowing this one, so it will not be high pass. So obviously, it is a low pass filter. So that means your B is connected with S. As simple as it is. So you take any value of RS, then you think. No need to remember all the circuits. Here also, second one also, you consider all 1-1. Then 1-1. Then you try using that one. What day we say? Nodal. But here you have to take two nodals, because this is also V0. This point is V0, because this is connected here, V0. And this position you don't know. So let me write it here X. This potential X or V, whatever. And this potential is at V0, because this is V0. So this is at V0. This is, so this node is V0. And this node you already be in. So unknown node is this one. So you have to take two nodal here. So first, if I take nodal at x, then for C I am doing, so it is x minus V naught by C1 is 1 by S, then plus x minus V naught by this current, that is also 1 by S, plus another current, x minus V naught, the upper current divided by 1. This is equal to 0. So from here, if you calculate, you will find 2 SX, sx sx, so 2sx, and then minus sbi minus sb0, and then plus x, and then minus b0 equal to 0. So you will find your, let us calculate x. So it will be 2s plus 1, x is equal to 2s plus 1, then it is b0 if you take common 1 plus s, and then sb. So we got a relation of something of this fashion. Let it be like that. We will put x from the second nodal, we will put it here because we need a relation between b0 and b. That's it. So for that one, we will take again nodal in this position here. At this position again two current, one is this, no current flowing through this. So this side is V0. So if you do this from this position, so it is V0 minus X by 1 by S, and then plus V0 by this one I have considered one. This is it. So if you do here, so here it will be X into V0 minus XS plus V0 equal to 0, or X is equal to, or SX equal to whatever, S plus 1 into V0. Or you can take s plus 1 by s v0. So you put it there, s plus 1 by s v0, and then 2s plus 1, and then v0 1 plus s, and then s into vi. So you take v0 one side common. So if you take v0, it will be s plus 1, 2s plus 1 by s minus 1 plus s, which is s into v0. So if you do a little bit now here, it will be 2s square plus s plus 2s, 3s plus 1 minus s square, s into vi. So if you do here now, it will be v0 into, it will be s square plus 2s plus 1, which is equal to s square vi, which is your v0 will be equal to, v0 by vin will be equal to s by s plus 1 whole square of this much. So if you divide it, because for, if you are putting a 0 and infinity, for that you divide denominator by s, so it will be 1 by 1 plus 1 by this format you bring. Now it will look good. So in place of s, what you will put? 1 by j omega. Now you think, if for low pass you think omega equal to 0, for high pass you think omega equal to infinity, is high frequency. So if it is a low frequency, omega 0. So if you put 0, then it is infinite. So 1 by infinite, it will give you gain is 0. Gain 0 means no output. So obviously it will not be a low pass. Low is, it is not allowing low, because in case of low, you are getting 0. If you give high, if you give infinity here, then this side is 0, the gain is 1. You are getting a good gain, that is 1. That means you are getting output. So if you are getting output, that means it is a high pass filter. So that means your C will go to, high pass is P. So C will go with P. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.